Hello, welcome back to my channel. I am back home. I've been back home for a few days now, and I haven't had the chance to film anything. I was trying to edit something, but my editing program is just driving me crazy. I've been trying to edit my recent repaint. It's been like a whole month now since I finished it, but oh well. Anyways, it's just I have too much footage and I need to speed it up, and my editing program does some crazy stuff when I try to speed things up, but I will resolve that eventually. Anyways, it's another rainy day, but I've had a few sunny days in which I was out, and this is why I didn't film anything. But I did take a lot of pictures for my Instagram, which hopefully you're seeing right now on the screen. And yeah, now that it's finally rainy and I can't go out, I have some time to film another haul, and I'm gonna start right away. I went to... it's a big store where they basically sell everything. I needed to buy some essential things, and of course I went through the crafting and through the dough area, but there wasn't anything good in the dough area for me. But anyways, first I did pick these two markers. They are Faber-Castell. I don't know how you read that originally, but it's a brand that I use a lot. I just don't know how you pronounce it in English, but anyway, they're cool. I have tested them over here. I don't know if it's gonna show. Do you see the glitter? They are glittery. This is a concept art that I drew for future doll. Hopefully I will one day get to making her. Then I have two dolls that I'm gonna show you. The first one is this girl. This is Dana Treasure. I'm not very sure how you pronounce that, Jones. She's from Monster High, from the Shipwrecked series, and I think that she's a reboot though, but anyways, she was one of the characters that I still didn't have. She doesn't have her original shoes, these are just some AliExpress shoes that I gave her, and she is missing quite a few accessories, but I'm happy to add her to my collection, because I don't know if you know, I'm trying to finish my collection. And what do I mean finish? I want to collect every single character that was ever out from Monster High. At least I want to have at least one version of every character, and I will consider my collection complete. So she brings me one step closer. Honestly, she is not such a great dolly. Such a great quality, because she is a doll, and yeah, dolly. She's not such a great quality like most Monster High dolls, but she's a nice doll. Her hair was a little messed up, but I did that hairstyle for her. Can I focus? And she has molded on top, which I'm not very happy for that, but oh well. And she has a very interesting... let me get her off of that stand. Do you see? She has indent stars in her hands, but somehow they remind me of chew marks. She has them on her forehead. And also on her feet. But when I got her out from the mail box that she was in, she wasn't boxed, but you know, she was put in a box to be mailed to me. I thought that she was chewed on, and then I realized they were stars, which is very strange, let's say. And she has a gimmick with the dress. You can do that, and then you can twist it like so. And she has hair in her armpits, don't we all? And this goes like that. And now she is with a blue dress. Honestly, I like the black dress a lot more than the blue one, but the blue one is cute too. Yeah, that's her, and she's on a weird looking stand. This is a stand that I have made with help from my father-in-law. It's this part is the interesting. This is just a piece of wood that was left over. This is a chopstick from Chinese food. And this is something that they use in piping. You mount it to the wall like that, and you put the pipe through here. And it has different sizes, and you can use it to make a doll stand. This one works like that. It is made for Barbie, obviously, but I had it free, and it can be made to work for Monster High too. It's not the best stand in the world, but it works. And I do have the same one, the same type handmade stand. Nope, it doesn't want to focus on it. But anyways, it's the same thing. This is a chopstick, just a block of wood that I have spray painted. And again, this think that the camera doesn't want to focus on it, but it is for holding pipes, and this one is big enough so it can hold the waist of a Barbie doll. That's basically it. The next doll that I have is a weird one. It's this one, and I'm saying that she's weird because, well, she's a fake doll. She doesn't have She actually has something on the back of her head. It says barter. No idea what it means. And just made in China here. I think that she's very old, retro fake doll. And the reason that I got her is, first off, she was from the same store that this girl was sold in. And this girl was put on a bid, and I won her. And I looked through what other stuff the store had, and they had this girl. She was just like a door. In very sad condition. I will insert pictures here. Of her hair, and the white stuff, liquid stuff that you see on her hair is fabric softener, because I started preparing her to wash her, and I decided that I want to take some pictures, because if she restores, it's gonna be, you know, interesting transformation. And she did restore very nicely. She is not rooted very well, but she has enough hair to cover it. And the hair did restore pretty nice. There are sections in her hair that look brand new. Of course, there are a few sections like this one that has taken some damage, and even though I did a lot of boil washing, I couldn't restore it, but this section, for instance, is like brand new. She also did have a few plugs missing. There was a plug missing over here, so I just put blue thread in the plug and I braided these braids, and I did the same here but with different colored thread just for accent. And she's very hollow. Her entire body except for her hands is hollow. And while washing her, I made the mistake to pull her apart here, and it took me 2 hours to be able to snap back on that joint. Don't do that if you get dull like that. I just heard that she was filling with water. This part was full of water, and I wanted to get the water out, but getting that joint on her belly back on, it was very hard. But anyway, a little trick that I did for washing her hair. Before starting to wash her hair, I pulled her head apart like that because she has this joint. It's just a bowl. And I put some fabric glue inside her and I left her for 12 hours so the fabric glue can grab onto the hair and, you know, get dry. And this way, when I was washing and brushing and bowl washing, I didn't pull out too much hair. With those that are usually fake, they don't put glue in their hair, and this is why you pull the hair off very, very easily. This is why I did that. And she also, first off, she reminds me of the dolls that I had when I was little. I never had original Barbies when I was little. And I even have my first ever Barbie doll. she's not a Barbie doll, she's a fake doll, but you know, the first doll that I ever got. Let me just put this girl on the stand. Like so. My stands aren't pretty, but they work. Anyways, this is the first doll that I ever got as a child. It really is the first doll that I got as a child. She's completely hollow. She's like the quality of this one, but even lower quality, because this one's hands are rubber and they're very solid, and this one's hands are just hollow plastic. But anyway, this doll was preserved this way so well because I never played with her. I never liked her, first of all, because she had the short hair. Second, because I, even as a kid, I did make the difference between a Barbie and just a doll, you know. I did have other fake dolls as a kid, and I did play a lot with them, but I just didn't like this one when I was little. And honestly, I'm happy that I didn't like her, because now as a grown up I can appreciate her, and I'm happy that she was preserved this well. My other dolls are also preserved, but they need a lot of work to restore them. They are dirty, their hairs need new hairs, basically all of them, because they were like, this girl didn't have any glue in them, and every time when I brushed them as a kid, I did end up pulling out hair from their heads. Anyways, this girl reminded me of my old doll, and this is why I just, you know, I wanted to help her, to save her. And she also really reminds me of... Have you heard of gem and the holograms? Holograms? Yeah, holograms. This is how you say it in English, I think. Yeah, she reminds me of gem and the holograms. Maybe she was some sort of knockoff of gem and the holograms. And also, if she's not a knockoff, and you know the brand on the back of her head, which I have no idea what that is, please tell me, if you know anything about her, tell me. This is not what she came wearing. These are just some Barbie fashions that I had in my stock box. And these are just some AliExpress shoes that only fit that type of dolls. And this is why she got these things. She came wearing this, which is a nice skirt, but I didn't imagine her wearing a skirt like that. Anyways, other things that I have to show you is, first off, look at that bunch of fabric. This is the same fabric over and over and over again, but in different colors. This is, it was called maybe sampler. Is that sample? You know, these are samples for fabrics, basically. And it was at the thrift shop, and it was very dirty. And I got it, and I was with my mother, and she was like, what do you need that for? And to someone, this may look like very tiny pieces of fabric, but for those, you can make a lot of stuff. And the fact that you have the exact same fabric, but you know, I don't know, 20 maybe, I don't know how many they are, shades of it, to me, that gives me a lot of ideas and opportunities. So I will be using that for crafting in the future. And then I have a box of stuff, another thrifted thing that I will use for fabric, for crafting, for those stuff. Again, it's not a very big piece of fabric, but for those, it is big. It's gonna do. And then they might look a little bit disheveled, but I assure you, I can iron them and they will look like new. And they are again for crafting, because if you don't know, fabric flowers are usually very expensive, especially the pretty ones. And you never know when you're gonna need to use a petal for your doll's dresses. And this is why I got them. They were again at the thrift store, and they were like 10 cents a piece, so I got them for 10 cents. What I have next is some feathers, again for crafting. This year on Halloween I had prepared a craft for witches' hats, but I lost all of my footage. But the hats are here. Do I have one with feather? Be right back. I want to show. Sadly, all of the hats that have feathers on them from that craft are in my deep storage, basically. They're in the box, in a box, on the bottom of the boxes. And I'm not gonna try to get them, but yeah, for Halloween I do make hats like that, and maybe next year for Halloween I will show you how I make them. You can make all sorts of hats this way, but anyways, most of the hats, actually these are the only two that don't have feathers, but most of the hats I use feathers like these ones for them. And this year I did end up using up most of my feathers, and I did like the colors of these feathers that were in here. The next thing that I'm gonna show you One moment, please. Please stand by. No, I'm ready. A few fashion packs. I did remove them from their outer boxes because they were taking so much space, and I had to bring everything back at home, you know, from my parents' house. I'm now at my own house, and I just got them like that, and I'm not gonna unbox them right now because I don't want the video to get too long. I think it's already too long, like 16-17 minutes. But if you want to see how they look on a doll, go and follow me on my Instagram. I will take pictures with my dolls of them and with other fashions too. And then what I have here. Oh, these two are very interesting. They are fake icicles, basically. They look like they're melting, but they're made of plastic. But what I saw when I saw these two is the staff of a Ice Queen doll. And I'm gonna put them in my stock box, and when I'm making a nice queen kind of character, I'm gonna make her a staff out of these, because yeah, the moment I saw them, I saw something for my dolls. They are supposed to be Christmas decorations, you know, Christmas tree decorations, but yeah, to me they are stuff for my dolls. I do have nail polish, and you can see it here on my fingers. I'm wearing it, but it's obviously peeled off because that happens with my nails. I craft too much, basically, and I can never have my nails pretty. The next thing that I'm gonna show you is a baggie of crafting materials. I'm gonna remove the outer packaging because it's too noisy, and I'll be right back to show you the trims and everything that they have inside. There we have it. So this is just mermaid scales, would you call them? They're sequins on a thread, but they're very nice for doll crafts because you can make belts, you can make chokers, you can make head pieces from them. They give me, this little thing gives me so many crafting ideas, and you can never have too much of it. Also, just elastic. Again, you can never have too much of that because, you know, it is tiny, it's doll-sized, it's good for crafting. I have some, how do you call these, hoops, again, for crafting. And then these. I make doll earrings from them. I cut them to size, basically, I leave this much. And then I make the earring hanging from this. And they are great doll earrings. And then I have a few charms. This one, again, I picked because it looks like a Christmas decoration. They had a lot of tiny crowns in this store. These crowns, they may look too small for those, but I think they can make very cute, you know, like that, headpieces. I have two golden ones, and then I have two silver ones that have a different shape. You can also use these for Monster High bracelets because their hands are removable. I have this tiny tiny heart that I can make a choker out of it for my dolls. And then this cute little feather. Again, it's gonna make nice doll jewelry. And then I have this ring. It is something that my mom thrifted some time ago. And she doesn't use it as a ring. She just thrifted it because it was cheap and shiny. And she liked it. And she asked me if I can make something for my dolls out of it. And I will find a way to incorporate it in some of my dolls outfits. We will see. Maybe on a Monster High you can put it as a belt, even though it's a bit big. Then I have these weird... they're cute, but just weird stickers. I love stickers, but they were in this heart. It had something like the stickers on it. And it was in the supermarket, and it said surprise toy or something. And yeah, it's a surprise, but not a good one. Basically, I paid like $1.50 for this, and the only thing that was inside was this, the stickers, and some candy that was like the, you know, the Jelly Belly candy, if you know it, but it wasn't good. It was very hard and sticky to the teeth. So sure, they were surprised, but not a good one. And then the next thing that I'm gonna show you is basically Happy Mail, and I'm very happy. The first, everything came in this baggie, but I will get it out of the way because it's way too big. It's from my friend Vesi, who has an Instagram. I will link her Instagram. The first thing that she gave me is this amazing backpack. It's actual functioning backpack, as you can see. You can put a lot of stuff in it. Oh, and by the way, you can meet my new made to move doll. Let me just show her face, because the other day I took her out for some photo shoots. I will insert pictures. You can see more pictures of her on my Instagram. Again, come and follow me there, because I'm very active there. And yeah, that's her. She was a basic doll, basic Barbie, and she just has the prettiest huge smile ever. And yeah, she's wearing the amazing backpack from my friend Vesi. I do have a lot of things hand crocheted by my friend Vesi, and I love receiving stuff from her. The next thing that I had in my gift from Vesi is this amazing doll hat. Again, a lot of pictures of the hat on my Instagram. You can go and check it out. I will also insert them here in my video. And that's not all. Look at this. Again, I have pictures of it that you see to the side of the video, or, you know, somewhere on the screen. This is amazing. It's handmade jacket for dolls. It is absolutely soft and cute, and I love it. Thank you, Vesi, one more time. Kisses. And the last thing is something for me, which I can sadly no longer wear, because they're amazing earrings, but my ear holes closed in basically during quarantine, they had started to close, and when the quarantine stuff happened, I decided that I'm just gonna leave them to close, and then I'm gonna have my ears pierced again, because the original holes that I had on my ears were pierced somehow to the side. When I put long earrings, it was obvious that they weren't right. But anyway, in a few years, when I get my ears punctured again, I will most definitely wear those beautiful earrings here, like so. And the next thing that I'm gonna show is, again, I'm very happy person this month, is again happy mail. This time it is from Marna, from Dolls Rescued, here on YouTube. You probably know of her, but anyways, I did win these things. Let me just get them out of the packets, because they are noisy. The first thing from Marna is this very cute backpack. I love it, honestly. It is functional. These things are from a giveaway on Marna and Darren's channel. You should totally go and check them out. Not only for the giveaways, of course. The giveaways are just something cute that they do, but the channel is amazing. Who am I kidding? I know that you're here from their channel and you know of them because of them, basically. But anyways, thank you, Darren and Marna. I love this backpack, and I'm gonna change the straps and make them bigger, because I think that this backpack is gonna be perfect for my Kendall, because, you know, it's big and he has broad shoulders, and it's gonna look good on him, you know, backpack that big. I do have other backpacks, but they are all small and they look better on back for my girls. What's happening? Ah, nothing. My camera said something. I don't know what. I was looking at this anyways. I now have a backpack for my girls that fits, you know, very nicely. And I have for my boys. And then I did win two giveaways on their channel. These things, they are printed on a 3D printer, and they are awesome. This is monster high sized. They are bat ears. Can I somehow get them more visible? Yeah, look at how cute she is. I love that. And the other few things that we have in here are doll shoes. How do you call this? Soles. They're the lower part of the shoe, basically, and they are for crafting. Whoops. There you can see, again printed by Darren, thank you, on their 3D printer. I have yellow pair, I have a gray pair, then I have black, very nice. And the last one is pink. And I'm gonna make some shoes using those. Thank you very much. You can never have too many monster high shoes, because especially when you're like me and you're collecting most of your dolls secondhand, you get dolls without shoes and you need shoes, and the dog is barking. Sorry about that. and I will show you how I make the shoes, maybe in separate video later, maybe this week or next week. I'm not very sure when I'm gonna find the time. I'm still on vacation, but I wanted to spend some time back home because I do have a lot of chores which I couldn't do while I was working, even though I was working from home. And when I find time for crafting, I will try to record what shoes I make from these awesome gifts. And this video is very long and it was supposed to be short anyways. Sorry about that, you know me, I keep on rambling. But yeah, I'm very happy for my two gifts, one by Marna and Darren and the other one from Vesi. And yeah, basically that's it. Thank you very much for watching. Leave me a like and comment if you know who this doll is, please tell me, because I really like her, even though she seems to be, you know, fake. And I'm not too much into retro dolls, but there is something about her that I really love. And yeah, I will see you next time. Bye-bye.